Student, we are not here to teach chemistry, but we are here to coach your chemistry. Actually, you have to learn yourself, okay? If the problem is there, teacher will create, solve your problem. I am actually problem solver. I am coach here, okay? Modern chemistry is actually based upon electronic configuration. Actually, chemistry is based upon electronic configuration. Chemistry, website of chemistry is electronic configuration. Okay, today we will discuss DNF block of element. Okay, see, this is your orbit number one, orbit number two, three, four, five, and so on. Orbit number one have only one sub-orbit, second have two sub-orbits, and so on, three sub-orbit, four sub-orbits, and so on. Okay, electron first occupy s orbit, hence atomic number 1 and 2 will be s block, 3 and 4 will be s block, 5 to 10 will be p block, 11, 12 will be s block, and 13 to 18 will be p block. Now it is rule, when a outermost orbit of any atom occupy 8 electron, new orbit electron goes to new orbit. However, former have capacity to attain more than 2 electron. Therefore, first d block start from fourth orbit. Okay, this is your 18, 19 and 20. Electron after 20 will occupy d block. This is your 2, 10, 18 and 20. Now incoming electron will go to d block. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30. Means first d block will be from 21 22 23 24 25 26 27 28 29 and 30. Remember, first d series is from 21 to 30. Now it is 30. Now electron go to p block, means from 31 to 36 will be p block. Again it is inert gas. Again it is 8. Now electron goes to s block. 37 and 38 will be s block. Again electron enter to d block, means 39 to 48 will be next d block. Okay, next will be 39 39 30 40 41 42 43 45 46 47 and 48. Again see, this is your 36. Next electron goes to s block, 37 38. Now incoming electron after 38 will be d block. Okay, so second D series start from 39 to 48, 39 to 48. Okay, now this is your 48. Again electron goes to P block, means 39, 48 onward, means up to 54 will be P block. Again inert gas. Now electron goes to S block, 55 and 56, S block. Now electron goes to D block. Means 57 will be, 57 will be D block. 57 will be D block. 57 will be D block. Now see, if we go by all the electron here, if suborbit remain vacant, hence the rule is outermost orbit have attained 2 electron and next outermost orbit have 8 plus 1 electron only, and it will remain constant. Okay, and now incoming electron goes to f orbital. F orbital, this is rule for filling of electron in f suborbit. Again repeat, this is your 54, 56 and 57. If electron occupy in D block, if suborbit remain as it is. Hence, D suborbit have only one electron and it become constant. Now incoming electron goes to F block. Means 56, 4, 56 and 57. 57 remain constant as it is. And new incoming electron goes to third outermost orbit. Okay, means electron from 57 onward will be F block, 58 and so on, 59 to 71, 14 electron. Means this is your 58 to 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70 and 71. Okay, again repeat. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Means F block have 14 electron. This F block is within T, third group. Be remember, F block is within third group. F block is within third group. Okay? Third group. F block is in third group. Again repeat. When outermost have attained 2 electron, next, last but one have 8 electron, 8 plus 1 electron, it remain constant. And last but 3 have attained remaining 14 electron in orbital F, suborbit F. Okay, hence electron from 58 to 71 will be F block. And again repeat, this remain constant. This is third group, hence F block in within third group. Its name is lanthanum, hence called lanthanides. Means first F block is from 58 to 79. It is within D block, hence called inner transition. D block is called transition because it is in between S and P. And F block is within D block, hence called inner transition. Transition. Since this remains constant and electron goes to last but three, means F block is within third group. Again, now this D orbit have only one electron, it have to occupy remaining 9 electron. Means remaining 9 electron will be D block. Means from 72 to 80 will be D block. 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79. Means third D group, third D series is not continuous. Only 57 is D block and remaining 14 is F block within third group. Okay? And then 9 more electron will be D block. Means D, third D series is not continuous. Okay. It will be very useful for F block discussion. You will see later on. Now again, this is your 80. Again, electron goes to P block. Means from 81 to 86 will be P block. 81 to 86 will be 81 to 86 will be P block. Okay? P block. Again inert gas. Now electron goes to S block. Means 87 and 88 will be S block. Now electron will go to D block as it is 1. Again, last orbit have 2 electron. Last but 1 have 8 plus 1 electron. It remain constant. Remain constant. Again, it is third group. Now, incoming electron goes to F orbital, F suborbit. Means, electron after 89, 92, 103. Again, see, this is your 86. According to Bohr theory, now electron goes to S orbit. 87, 88 will be S block. And it acquire only one electron because we have to fill F block. And this remain constant. Now this is third group. It remain as it is. And new incoming electron goes to second F series from 92, 103. This is your 89 actinium. It remain as it is. Now next electron goes to F block, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102. Means second F series, is from 89 onward. Since its name is actinide, it is within third group, it is actinum, hence called actinide. It is called actinoids. It is also within D block, hence also called inert transition. Okay. Now our topic is actually D and F block. So again repeat, first D series is from 21 to 30, okay? Second D series is from 39 to 48. It is continuous. It is continuous. Okay, third D series is from 57. It remain as it is. Now, remaining 14 electron goes to F block. Okay. Hence, from 58 to 71 will be F block, and again 72 to 80 will be D block. 72, 73 to 80. Discontinue. Okay. Means third D series is not continuous. There is vacancy of 14 electron which go within the same orbit. Okay, and now D4 is from 89. Remaining electron goes to F block, and again 112 will be discontinued. It will be onward, means 104, 105, 106, 7, 8, 109, 110, 111, and 112. Okay. Means first D series is from 21 to 30. It is continuous. Second D series is from 39 to 48. It is also continuous. No breaking. But the third D series and 4 is not continuous. 14 electron is within F block, hence it is 57, and remaining 14 will be F block, 72 to 80, and again D4 series 89, remaining 14 is F block, and 104 to 112 is D block. Okay, now we will discuss electronic configuration. Okay, very important. It is scandium. Scandium T टिटानियम, वैनाडियम, क्रोमियम, मैग्नीज, आयरन, कोबाल्ट, निकल, कॉपर एंड जिंक. ओके, इन दिस केस आउटर मोस्ट ऑर्बिट हैव S2 एंड D1. इन दिस केस S2 एंड D2, S2 एंड D3 मीन्स आउटर मोस्ट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इज S2 एंड D1. इन दिस केस S2 एंड D2, इन दिस केस S2 एंड D3, S2 एंड D4, S2 एंड D5, S2 एंड D6, S2 D7, S2 D8, S2 D9 and S2 D10. Very important to discuss D and F block element. Always remember outermost electronic configuration. Of course, in case of D1, it will be 4 and 3. In this case, it will be 5 and 4. In this case, 6 and 4, 5, 7 and 6. Okay, for this series, outermost electronic configuration is S2D1, S2D2, S2D3, S2D4, S2D5, S2D6 and so on, D7, S2D8, S2D9 and D2. Okay, but this configuration will be actually S1 and D5. In this case, it will be S1 and D10. Again, it is discussed on the basis of electronic configuration. In the case of chromium, okay, 2, 8 and 18, 20 and 24, 24, S2 and D5, S2 and D5, 4 and 3. D have 5 orbitals. D have 5 orbitals, S have 1 orbitals, 2 electron, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, 4. This is D4, this is D5, okay. According to Hund's rule, orbital will be stable if it is symmetrical. Symmetrical means all the orbitals have either 1-1 electron or 2-2 electron. It will be stable. Okay, according to Hund's rule, the orbital, if it is symmetrical, means have same type of electron, 1-1-1 or 2-2-2, it will be stable, otherwise unstable. Hence, it is unstable. Unstable because this have 1-1-1 and no electron. If the electron is this one, 1-1-1-1, N1 and D1, it will be stable. Hence D4 become D5 and it become S1. So in the case of this 6 group, outermost electronic configuration will be S1D5 rather than S2D4. We remember, in this case, 6 group, outermost electronic configuration will be S1D5 rather than S2D4 because this is stable configuration. Similar is the case with copper group, 11th group. This 2, 8, 18, 20 and 9. In this case, there is 9 electron. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 2 electron. Again, it is unstable. Okay? If electron is paired one, it is symmetrical, and it will be 1. It is stable. Hence, 11th group, actual outermost electronic configuration is S1D10 rather than S2D9 due to symmetry of orbitals. Okay, remember. It's very important to remember outer most electronic configuration. It is actually S1N D5 is actually S1N D10. Okay, now we will discuss one by one. Scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, and zinc. In this group, next one is ytterbium, lanthanum, actinium. Okay. In this case, there is titanium, zirconium, hafnium. This is your vanadium, niobium, tantalum. This is your chromium, molybdenum, tungsten. Manganese, technetium, ruthenium, osmium, rhodium, iridium, nickel, palladium, platinum, copper, silver, gold, zinc, cadmium or mercury. So third group, outermost electronic configuration will be S2D1 and so on. Fourth will be S2D2, fifth will be S2D3, and this will be S1D5 rather than S2 because of stability. And again S2D5, S2D6, S2D7, S2D1, S1D10 rather than S19, S2D10. Okay, now we will see number of unpaired electron, because unpaired electron play vital role in discussion of DNF block element, magnetic properties, color of the compound, etc. is based upon unpaired electron. Okay, in case of D1 structure, unpaired electron is 1. Unpaired electron, D1, unpaired electron is 1. In case of D2, unpaired electron is 2. In case of D3, unpaired electron is 3. In case of D4, unpaired electron is 4. And D5, unpaired electron is 5. Very, very important. If our most electronic configuration is D1, unpaired electron is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If there is 9 electron, D9, unpaired electron is same. If it is D8, unpaired electron is also same. D3 and D7, unpaired electron is also same. And D6, unpaired electron is also 4, same. Okay, so 1 and 9, 10, 2 and 8, 10, 3 and 7, 10, 4 and 6, 10, V5. Means number of unpaired electron is D1. In D9 is same, it is 1. Okay? In case of D2 and D2, 8, same. Unpaired is 2. D3 and D7, unpaired is 3. D4 and D6, unpaired is 4. Means 1 and 9, 10, 2 and 8, 10, 3 and 7, 10, 4 and 6, 10, 5 and 5, 10. Very important for solving problem in competition. Very easy to remember. Okay? Now we will discuss the properties of D block. Okay. Now see. This is your scandium, first member. 21, and of course same ytterbium, lanthanum, actinium. Okay, scandium means 2, 8, 18 and 2 and D1. Okay, D1. Here 4s2 and 3d1. 3d1. 4s2, 3d1. 4s2. And 3d1. Okay, I also remember energy level of 4s and 3d is as good as same. Energy level of 4s, 2 and 3d is as always same. Okay, now we will discuss number one point, oxidation state. See, first of all, this scandium will lose 2 electrons, means it will have plus 2 oxidation state, and again 1 means 1 plus 2 plus 3, means oxidation state of scandium, oxidation state of scandium is plus 2 and plus 3. Okay, in case of plus 2, this is one unpaired electron. Okay, it will be paramagnetic and colored. For magnetic property, if electron is unpaired, it is will be paramagnetic or ferromagnetic. If electron is paired one, it will be diamagnetic, non-magnetic. So in case of scandium plus 2, there is D1 electron, hence it will be colored and paramagnetic. Remember, in case of S plus 3, there is no electron, hence diamagnetic and colorless. Means, on the basis of electronic configuration, we can obtain oxygen state as well as magnetic property as well as color of compound. Again, for example, scandium. Scandium as element should be colored because it has one electron. But when lost electron, 2, again it has one unpaired electron, scandium plus 2 will be